We are going to add one more smart home control bubble to control the Christmas tree lights. We need a little preparation for the kind of switches I have. So I go into if this then that, and we are going to add two web hooks. One is going to turn it on and the other one is to turn it off. This is a web hook. We are going to call this one Xmas tree underscore on. And it's going to simply turn on my Christmas tree lights. Turn on or off, on. And we will need another one, which will turn it off. So here we go. We select the same Christmas tree lights. And this time I pick off. So we have created two web hooks. One is called Christmas tree on and the other one is called Christmas tree off. Now we are back to our bubble clouds and I'm first going to add it to my home screen widget. Using the pencil icon and then the plus sign, we can add a new smart home control HTTP bubble. We're going to call this one Xmas tree. We're going to pick a picture for it. I already took a picture of my beautiful Christmas tree. I'm just going to take this crop, and for color, you're going to use this same yellow color that I used for my desk in the office. So the office has this yellow color. And now here comes the command, which will be pretty easy because Bubble Clouds has the if this then that maker event template built into it. So I can choose that template right there. And you can see there are two parts I will have to fill. One is the event name and the other one is my maker key, which I can get from the if this then that website. So here for the event name, we can type Christmas tree underscore and we could put on here. And then this would turn on the Christmas tree. And then we could add another one which has off in it and it would turn it off, but that's two bubbles. Instead, what we can do is to add a toggle field. Just by checking here, it adds that blank toggle field for us, two square brackets and a pipe character between them. So we could type the two options on and off here. And if we wanted, we could add one more pipe character and a third state. But usually two is enough. This way the command will first be issued with the word on. The second time we issue the command, it's going to use the event name Christmas tree off. So it will alternate between these two. Now instead of typing this key, I'm going to show you another cool thing. We have all our previously added HTTP commands here. So I can choose one of the previous ones, for example, the one that toggled the sync, and you can see it already has my maker key in it, and it also has this toggle field in it. So I can just go there to the word sync and change that to a Christmas tree. We can already go ahead and test this. And it's going to give us this positive feedback that we did it correctly. And you can see the first time it said Christmas tree on event was fired. The second time I press it, the off event is fired. So it toggles between the two. So that's it. At this point, I can press add and we have added this new bubble to our widget. And here we can already try it. If I click on it, it's going to turn on the Christmas tree. Now we are going to add the same bubble to the watch. And for this, we have to open Bubble Clouds, go to the Wear Cloud Editor. And here you can already see my smart home control bubbles. We are just going to add one more. The size of each of them is -7. This causes them to appear on the same page in my app drawer. So the next one we are going to add is again the Christmas tree image. I do the same crop. I set the same color. I change the size to -7. We will name it Christmas tree also. Adding the command is even easier because it's already in our list since we added it to our home screen widgets. So I can just pick it from right here. I can test. Of course it works. We can simply press add and this bubble is now added to the others. So you can see right there, and it's also on my watch. And watch. It also works. I hope with this new feature, Bubble Cloud Widgets and Watch Face Launcher has made another big leap in versatility. Now it puts the control of your smart home devices right on your wrists and at your fingertips. Please don't take the development of this app for granted though. My app is receiving a tremendous amount of bad ratings lately. The haters are always louder than the silent majority, but the current Play Store review system amplifies their voice. If you like the app, please support the project by leaving a 5-star review. Thank you.